Magandang araw, kapamilya. Today is Monday of the fourth week in Ordinary Time. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. Save us, O Lord our God, and gather us from the nations, to give thanks to your holy name, and make it our glory to praise you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Grant us, Lord our God, that we may honor you with all our mind and love everyone in truth of heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, what more shall I say? I have not time to tell of Gideon, Barak, Samson, Jephthah, of David and Samuel, and the prophets, who by faith conquered kingdoms, did what was righteous, obtained the promises. They closed the mouths of lions, put out raging fires, escaped the devouring sword. Out of weakness they were made powerful, became strong in battle, and turned back foreign invaders. Women received back their dead through resurrection. Some were tortured and would not accept deliverance in order to obtain a better resurrection. Others endured mockery, scourging, even chains and imprisonment. They were stoned, sawed in two, put to death at sword's point. They went about in skins of sheep or goats, needy, afflicted, tormented. The world was not worthy of them. They wandered about in deserts and on mountains, in caves and in crevices in the earth. Yet all these, though approved because of their faith, did not receive what had been promised. God had foreseen something better for us, so that without us they should not be made perfect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Let your hearts take comfort, all who hope in the Lord.
Let your hearts take comfort, all who hope in the Lord.
How great is the goodness of the Lord, which you have in store for those who fear you, and which, toward those who take refuge in you, you show in the sight of the children of men.
Let your hearts take comfort, all who hope in the Lord.
You hide them in the shelter of your presence, from the plottings of men. You screen them within your abode from the strife of tongues.
Let your hearts take comfort, all who hope in the Lord.
Blessed be the Lord, whose wondrous mercy he has shown me in a fortified city.
Let your hearts take comfort, all who hope in the Lord.
Once I said in my anguish, I am cut off from your sight, yet you heard the sound of my pleading when I cried out to you.
Let your hearts take comfort, all who hope in the Lord.
Love the Lord, all you his faithful ones. The Lord keeps those who are constant, but more than requites those who act proudly.
Let your hearts take comfort, all who hope in the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia. A great prophet has arisen in our midst, and God has visited his people. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus and his disciples came to the other side of the sea, to the territory of the Gerasenes. When he got out of the boat, at once a man from the tombs who had an unclean spirit met him. The man had been dwelling among the tombs, and no one could restrain him any longer, even with a chain. In fact, he had frequently been bound with shackles and chains, but the chains had been pulled apart by him, and the shackles smashed, and no one was strong enough to subdue him. night and day among the tombs and on the hillsides. He was always crying out and bruising himself with stones. Catching sight of Jesus from a distance, he ran up and prostrated himself before him, crying out in a loud voice, "What have you to do with me, Jesus, Son of the Most High God? I adjure you, by God, do not torment me." He had been saying to him, "Unclean spirit, come out of the man." He asked him, "What is your name?" He replied, "Legion is my name. There are many of us." And he pleaded earnestly with him not to drive them away from that territory. Now a large herd of swine was feeding there on the hillside, and they pleaded with him, "Send us into the swine, let us enter them." And he let them, and the unclean spirits came out and entered the swine. The herd of about 2,000 rushed down a steep bank into the sea, where they were drowned. The swineherds ran away and reported the incident in the town and throughout the countryside. And people came out to see what had happened. As they approached Jesus, they caught sight of the man who had been possessed by legion, sitting there, clothed and in his right mind. And they were seized with fear. Those who witnessed the incident explained to them what had happened to the possessed man and to the swine. Then they began to beg him to leave their district. As he was getting into the boat, the man who had been possessed pleaded to remain with him. But Jesus would not permit him and told him instead, "Go home to your family and announce to them all that the Lord in his pity had done for you." Then the man went off and began to proclaim in the Decapolis what Jesus had done for him, and all were amazed. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You know, this is a very interesting, again, a very interesting gospel. No? But let me just sort of situate our reflections, no? Because I'd like to sort of introduce a general theme, no, for today's gospel and tomorrow's gospel. There you see the sensitivity and the compassion of Christ, no, today and tomorrow, no. The gospel. Tomorrow you have another healing, a series of healing stories actually tomorrow. And what I'd like to propose today for our reflection is, of course, this is a classic gospel of the presence of evil in the world. No, but what I want to focus on is the sensitivity of Christ. No, the sensitivity of Christ to the man's inner working, so to speak. No, what is going on in his mind. No. And then, of course, tomorrow you will see that sensitivity again. So siguro yun yung gusto ko lang bigyan ng diin dito. No? Kasi ngayon nga at bukas, yung ating ebanghelyo at pagninilay natin ay tungkol sa kung papaano nakikiisa ang Panginoon sa ating damdamin. No? Yung kanyang pagkahabag at yung kanyang pakikiisa sa dinaraanan natin sa ating kalooban. No? So yun yung magiging, kumbaga, overall na tema. No? Kasi makikita nga natin, parang maganda 'tong pagnilayan yung presensya ng kasamaan, no, sa mundo, pero nais kong bigyan pansin at bigyan diin yung pagiging sensitibo ng Panginoon sa mga tao, no, sa atin, no. Maybe that first point, no, that Jesus was very much aware and understood what was going on in the mind of the man who was possessed, no. And then here the second point is again related to his concern for us, for people. Yung second point na pagdinilayan natin, the primacy he gives to the human person, na higit sa lahat ang mahalaga ay ang tao. And then number two and the last one is to take a look at the reactions, ano, of the crowds, because you have two sets of crowds. No, one is the ones who went to the site, no, when they heard that the man had been exorcised and the spirits were sent into the swine, no? And then you have later on, when the man proclaims to the Decapolis, the people were so amazed, no? So yung reaction ng tao, no? Siguro yung pangatlong punto, yung kanilang reaction sa ginawa ng Panginoon. So first, let's take a look at that, how the Lord understood the man, no? I think what we need to bear in mind, during that period of the Lord, people were very, very, I guess now we will call it very superstitious, no? That they believe very much in possession. In fact, they linked a lot of illnesses to being sinful. They linked a lot of sins, or rather a lot of their illnesses also to possession. So there's a lot of superstition during that time, no? And according to some commentaries, no, that most probably this man who was already perhaps there were some mental issues going on, but again the power of suggestion, no? And remember that time they believed very much in possession. So the Lord understood that, no? The Lord understood that. That's why the Lord was exorcising him, remember, telling him to leave him, and then asking him, "Who are you? And we are many," etc. And the interesting thing here is that the man needed proof that he was already freed from the evil spirits, no? And that is why he asked that the evil spirit be sent to the swine, no? That's one thing that I think that we tend to overlook, no? That according to some commentaries and some reflections on this gospel, the man was wanted to be healed, but at the same time he wanted proof, no, that the demons are away. That's why he asked that, and the Lord agreed, no, that it be sent to the swine, to the herd of swines. So siguro yung unang punto na yan, ano, na doon mo makikita kung gaano niya nauunawa ang siguro ang tawag natin sa Pilipino, kung paano niya sinasakyan yung nangyayari sa kaisipan ng mama. Kasi nga, di ba, paniwalang paniwala siya dito sa mga pamahiin na ito nung araw. And yun yung galing ng Panginoon, ano? Nauunawaan niya ang dinaraanan ng tao. Nauunawaan niya. Hindi, sabi ko nga, di ba, hindi generic yung paggamot ng Panginoon. The Lord's healing was never generic. But He understood what was going on in the interior movements and struggles of the person. At kitang-kita na nga natin to dito sa Ebanghelyo ngayong araw. Na alam mo, higit dun sa struggle ng mabuti at masama, yung struggle ng tao, ng mama, na gusto niyang makita na merong prueba na wala na talaga yung mga masamang espiritu. Kaya pinadala ng Panginoon dun sa mga baboy. Ano? Siguro that first point, no, to realize how much the Lord understood, no, and really work within that mindset of the person. And then the second point is very much related to that, no? The primacy he gave to the person. That's why he patiently, in a sense, in quotation marks, negotiated with the man, with the evil spirit in the man. And that's why he sent he sacrificed the swine for the sake of the person, no? Of course, the some people who are in a sense a certain level of what you call purist or what, di ba? Bakit daw sinacrifice yung maraming libu-libong baboy, ano? But again, for me, the symbol of this is for Christ, the person was the most important element of creation, no? The primacy of the man, the primacy of the human person. And I think that's very, very important, no, for us to realize, no, that in the mindset of the Lord, that was for Him very important. Siguro yung pangalawang punto na yun, no? Na makita natin yung napakalalim na pagpapahalaga ng Panginoon sa tao. Kaya nga sinakripisyo niya yung libu-libong mga baboy, ano, para lang mapagaling yung tao, yung mama, no? And then the third and last point is the reaction of people. Again, in many healing stories, in many miracles, no, there's always that different reactions, ano. So when news came out, because the one who took care of the herd went to the town and who presumably he witnessed everything, no, and told them what had happened. And then you see all of these people coming, ano, mga marites, no, they're all of them coming trying to check what was going on. But the interesting thing is their reaction: fear, and then asking Jesus to leave. That kind of throws you off, no? You would think that they would ask him to stay because he had expelled the demon from this man who was terrorizing actually the community, no? People didn't want to go near the tombs because they were terrorized by him, no? And yet, you know, you ask yourself, what was that reaction, no? It's very interesting because you realize that, you know, people were already used to that kind of balance, if you wish, no? the possessed man was there and they avoided the tombs. But here you have something out of the ordinary that takes place. And also, you have these thousands of swine drowning, no? So for them, it was a very jarring. It kind of broke their comfort zone, no? And broke their framework. That's why they begged him to leave, no? And I guess sometimes that happens to us, no? And sometimes we fail to see the presence of grace, especially when it jars our routine, when it jars our comfort zone, no? That one reaction, no? That one reaction. But then you see the reaction of the man, how he wanted to go with the Lord, how he wanted to become a disciple, no? And yet the Lord says, no, go back to your family, go back to your community, no? And tell them what the Lord has done for you. And he witnesses to the Lord, no? And then the reaction of the people that to whom he witnessed, that they were amazed by what the Lord did. So makita natin yung iba't ibang reaksyon ng tao sa Panginoon, no? Una, yung mga tao na lumabas, sabi ko, yung mga Marites, no, gusto nila makita kung ano nangyayari. And sila yung ano, parang nakakagulat yung kanilang reaksyon. Imbis na matuwa, magpasalamat, na nawala na yung masamang espiritu, parang pinaalis nila ang Panginoon, natakot sila, pinaalis nila. Kasi parang ano, no, nabagabag yung kanilang comfort zone, nabagabag yung kanilang nakasanayan na. And kumisang ganun tayo, no? Kaya kumisang hindi natin nakikita yung presensya ng biyaya at galaw ng Espiritu ng Diyos. Pero yung reaksyon naman nung mamang nagamot, no? Gusto niyang maging disipulo. Gusto niyang sumunod sa Panginoon. Pero sabi ng Panginoon, hindi, bumalik ka sa iyong pamilya at sabihin mo kung anong ginawa ng Diyos para sa iyo. At saka ano, nagsaksi siya, no? Bumalik siya doon sa bayan at sinabi niya kung anong ginawa. At dahil doon, maraming namangha, ano, doon sa ginawa ng Panginoon. So today let us reflect on this very interesting gospel. Again, I always say it's interesting because, you know, every time we reflect on the gospel, it actually becomes interesting, no? Because it's interesting because it speaks to our experience. And I hope there is something that you can reflect on. You don't need to reflect on everything, but there's something you can reflect on in the points that we shared that will somehow help you become a closer follower of Christ. Gathered together in Christ who conquers all evil, let us come confidently to the Father with our prayerful intentions.
That the Holy Father, the bishops, priests, and deacons may help us to remain strong in our faith in Christ, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Christian believers may have the courage to speak boldly in the name of Jesus Christ, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are hardened in sin may be touched by the Spirit of the Lord to repent and change their ways, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. For all this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O Lord, we bring to your altar these offerings of our service. Be pleased to receive them, we pray, and transform them into the sacrament of our redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. With love we celebrate his death. With living faith we proclaim his resurrection. With unwavering hope, we await his return in glory. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father most holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you." Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now, let us offer our prayer of humble faith and hope.
Merciful and compassionate Father, we humbly come before you in faith and hope. Grant us your grace and guidance as we emerge from this pandemic. We thank you for the blessings that saw us through the challenges of the past years. Reward those who selflessly served and continue to serve our many needs. Console those who suffered. Heal the sick. Grant eternal rest to those who died. May we draw inspiration from our collective and individual experiences. Let our hearts burn within us to build a world closer to your kingdom of justice, truth, equality, peace, joy, faith, hope, compassion, and love. May each of us be a bright candle to remind us that light will overcome darkness and never the other way around. We pray for our nation. Give us the courage and inspiration to relentlessly take part in the project of building a nation that our founding fathers envisioned over a century ago, and to which succeeding generations offer their lives in dedicated service, some to the point of martyrdom. Heroes, also Filipinos, may continue to work for freedom and someday truly be free. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Lady of the Immaculate Conception, Patroness of the Philippines,
pray for us.
Our Lady, Help of all Christians and Health of the Sick,
pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Roch,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus,
have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu,
have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy,
have mercy on us. And let us pray. Nourished by these redeeming gifts, we pray, O Lord, that through this help to eternal salvation, true faith may ever increase, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
On Thursday, ano, Piesta ng Candelaria, Feast of the Presentation and the Blessing of the Candle. So, if you wish, we will pray over your candles. And then, if you have holy water, you can sprinkle the candles with holy water on Thursday. That is the Feast of the Presentation, February 2. Maraming pong salamat. Have a good day ahead and have a good week ahead. Thank you.
In 2022, we received more than 60 million pesos worth of donations from you. Hindi po matatawaran ang tulong at suporta na inyong ibinigay upang tayo sa Caritas Philippines ay makapagbahagi din ng tulong sa mga pamilyang nasalanta ng bagyo, iginupo ng lindol, mga nasadlak sa baha at patuloy na nahihirapan dahil sa COVID-19 pandemic. We also utilized your donations to send children to school, feed families, provide livelihoods in food security, advocate for justice, help in peace building, and protect our environment better. Tunay ngang kapag patuloy ang ating pagmamalasakit, pagbabahagi, at pag-aalay kapwa, mas maraming Pilipino ang gumagaan ang buhay.
Tandaan po natin, sa pag-aalay kapwa, may pag-asa ang bagong taon.